So one of my current research projects is extracting information about where the roads are from the GPS data collected from vehicles and smartphones. Why would we want to do that? Maps are very important because we use them to get to where we want to go, and even self-driving vehicles will need maps to get to where they need to go. Collecting maps is not trivial. It's an expensive proposition. Why? In the past, maps were collected by people going around surveying instruments, labor-intensive process. Since then, specially equipped vehicles were used to drive around and collect information about where the roads are. But even that is not done often enough. It's done maybe once in 3 months, once in 6 months, which means that if a road is closed or if a new road is open, that is not reflected in the maps. By actually collecting data in real time from vehicles, because vehicles have these GPS sensors in them, we should be able to provide more accurate and more real-time information about where the roads are. And that's what our research is aiming to do. So the technical challenges in trying to extract road maps from the GPS data include the fact that GPS itself is erroneous. There are maybe about 3 meters of error in the GPS locations. GPS data from different vehicles is uncoordinated because every driver is doing his own thing. So the vehicles are not providing data in a coordinated manner. The vehicles are also being driven at different speeds, which means the data is coming to us at different rates. So the technical challenge is to put all this data together to extract accurate information about where roads are. And our signal processing algorithms do precisely that. While our research focus currently is on inferring maps from GPS data, the general principles of signal processing methods that we're developing can be applied in many other domains. For example, we can use the accelerometer data from multiple vehicles to estimate where potholes might be on the road, or what is the surface roughness of a road, so that the municipalities can actually use that information to do whatever repairs are needed. So these kinds of approaches are useful for extracting information from data collected from sensors in vehicles, but not just vehicles, even smartphones that the passengers in those vehicles are carrying. So this is a very general methodology. If we are deliberate in understanding what kind of information is being passively collected through our normal daily operations, like driving to work or going back home from work, there is information to be extracted from this passively collected data. It requires carefully developed algorithms, machine learning and signal processing algorithms, but that philosophy can be applied to many other domains.